Turn with me to the book of Psalms, chapter number 46. Psalms 46. And I just want to look at a few things tonight as we look at Psalms 46. Of the Lord and the faithfulness of God. There's a few things that I want to look at. A few things that we need to be aware of first, and then we'll move and look at the blessing of God's faithfulness. But we're looking at why we need that. And so in Psalms 46, the Bible says, God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in the time of help and trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth be removed, and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea, though the waters thereof roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with the swelling thereof, Selah. There is a river, the streams whereof shall make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacle of the Most High. God is in the midst of her. She shall not be moved. God shall help her. And that right early, the heathen raged. The kingdoms were moved. He uttered his voice. The earth melted. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Selah. Amen. What an incredible tonight. Testimony of the promises of God. Amen. That the psalmist writes that God is our strength and that God is our refuge and that He is, and I like how the psalmist writes it, He is a very present help in a time of trouble. Very present help in a time of trouble. And I like what in the book of 2 Chronicles, chapter number 15, Azariah told Asa that the Lord would always be with him as long as he was with the Lord. And if you look for God and you set your face toward Him, He will always be found of you. That's a good promise tonight. Now, I know tonight, I'm not saying right now anything that we don't know. But we do know it sometimes, but I'm not sure we always practice it the way that we say that we know it. And Azariah, he said there in 2 Chronicles chapter number 15 and verse number 4, but when they were in their trouble, they turned to the Lord of Israel and sought Him. And the Bible says, and He, God, was found of them. Amen. When we seek for God, when we look for God, God will be found of us. Amen. We need to latch on. We need to grab on to the promise of God that God is with us. And knowing that, particularly in this passage of Scripture, the Bible says there's never a need to fear or be afraid again because God is with us. Amen. Really, fear has to go. Amen. I'm saying this tonight because I know that we can struggle with that. I can struggle with that. Because we can say, I know it. But when we get there, it can be a fearful place. But God doesn't want us to be afraid. God doesn't want us to fear. Because He said, therefore, will not we fear. And He goes on down to say several things. He says, no matter how much turmoil the world is in, I'll get to more specifics of that in a second. No matter how much turmoil the world is in, I will not be afraid. There's a lot of folks who are really afraid right now of what's happening just worldwide. Disease, war, rumors of war, dearth
pray. That's not the characteristics of the believer tonight. Because the Word of God says that God is our refuge and our strength, a very present help in a time of trouble. Therefore, we will not fear. Amen. The Bible says, though the earth be removed, amen, it doesn't matter what happens in this world. If it's full of turmoil, amen, the earthquakes or the ocean swells or the mountains crumble into the sea, amen, everything can be in total uproar. Everything can be in chaos. But the thing that we need to realize is that God is our protector and God is our provider, and we can have peace flowing like a river. Hallelujah. That is a great promise. Amen. That is a great relationship. That is a great place to be. And though we may hear this over and over again, it's knowing that we need to be there. What would you do if you were at a place where the earth was falling apart, literally? Day or night, God's promise is that He tells us that He will always be there with us. The Message kind of says it this way. The Message translation. Sometimes I'll read different translations. I don't endorse them. I think we need to stick with King James. But I like some of the wording. Let me share. God is a safe place to hide, ready to help whenever we need Him. He's steadfastness at the cliff, at the sea storm and the earthquake, before the rush of oceans, tremors that shift mountains. God is right before us. God lives here, and the streets are safe. I like that vocabulary, if you would. Amen. The streets are safe. When we stand at the edge of the cliff, and the mountain shakes, the sea is raging, God is right there. We don't have to be afraid, because God is for us. I'm going to ask you tonight, I'm going to give you several verses we're going to be looking at throughout the course of the night. Just going to have you read. I'm going to share these kind of quickly, but if some folks can look these up. 1 Peter 1:4. Romans 7:21. Ephesians 6:12. 1 Peter 5:8-9. Luke 22:31. 1 Thessalonians 2:18. John 8:44. I think I'll stop there because I can't read my own handwriting.
It's a terrible thing, isn't it?
Amen. I didn't assign any of those, but
what was the Luke one?
Luke 22:31. Amen. To be frank with us tonight, I wonder if we comprehend the presence of God and His being with us. Do we truly and fully comprehend that? Amen. Most of us, if we were really honest with ourselves tonight, if we really thought it through, I wonder if we would say there is a bit of an inadequacy in my life in fully understanding the consistency of God's presence and God being with us. I think I would have to raise my hand, because there are moments in life where maybe I need to remind myself of just God's abiding presence. Amen. And I believe that God, and even particularly tonight, that God divinely wants to help the concept of us understanding who He is and how He wants to help us. God wants to do that. Amen. He wants us to know that when we face deep needs and very troubling times, that God is with us. Amen. When we encounter temptation, trials, confusion, quakes of the soul, and if you ever have a quake of the soul, amen, God wants us to know face them. But it's understanding that nothing ever takes God by surprise. He knows the seasons. He controls them. I know some people say, well, the moon controls the tides. Don't get confused. God controls the moon. God's keeping the tides in place. You notice it's darker a little later in the morning. It's darker a little early in the evening. God has it all in control. He's taking control of it. God knows. God knows the seasons. He has it all together. And if we in our life, amen, ever give in to fear, it can sometimes be full of despair. It can. When we can say, God, I'm fearful of this situation. But if we would just wrap our mind around the concept that God is a refuge and a strength and a very present help in a time of trouble, fear would have to go. There wouldn't be that despairing place that often we can find ourselves in. Amen. Because the realization that God is there, when it becomes a reality, it'll change everything. It's making sure God is there. Making sure we understand that reality for those moments where the earth quakes, where the ocean rolls. We're going to have those moments. It's inevitable. But we need to know that God is faithful. And He is at our service morning, noon, and night when we live by faith. God is at our service. I said it earlier tonight, it's not like it's room service. God, I need this. God doesn't owe us anything. But because we love Him and because we're faithful to Him, God has promised to be faithful to us. And His Word says that He is a very present help in a time of trouble. Amen. And that we don't have to fear. Amen. Though the earth be removed. You know what? I'm not worried about Ebola. No. I'm not. It is a big thing in our world today, particularly overseas, but it's a big thing right now. We already know about Ebola in Texas. The nurse fly with the fever to Cleveland. Amen. They quarantined some of those folks. They quarantined 70 folks from Texas Hospital. But we don't need to be afraid. Let me say this. It doesn't mean we don't need to be proactive. You know, if I know someone has a fever and they've been to West Africa, I ain't going to be hanging out their house all week. And I'm going to wash my hands. And if I'm at the hospital working and someone comes in, I know how to get on up and do my job. But I'm not going to sit around and fear about it. You know what? ISIS, I'm not going to. We don't need to be afraid. And I'm not fearful of a collapse in government. God will take care of us. God is faithful. So I want to read 2 Peter 1:4. 2 Peter 1:4. I might have. I wrote it down 2 Peter, but I said 1 Peter.
Whereby you are given unto us exceeding great and precious promises. Is that the one?
That's right.
That by these you might be partakers of the divine nature, having escaped the corruption that is in the world through lust.
We have been given great and precious promises. The promise is right here, that God is a very present help in a time of trouble. He is a refuge and He is a strength. We need to live in those promises because God is faithful. Amen. I want you to say to your neighbor, say, God lives in my streets. Yeah, say it to your neighbor. God lives in my streets. We don't need to be afraid at night. We don't need to be afraid of what's happening in town. I'm not necessarily talking about the streets and life. I'm just talking about life in general. God lives in our streets. We don't have to be afraid. God is faithful. He's going to watch over us and He's going to protect us. Amen. We can have peace that is like a river, like the psalmist talks about here in Psalms chapter number 46. There are some things that we need to realize tonight. Amen. Three things that I want to look at. And the first thing is this. is that we live in a world where there is ever-present evil. There is ever-present evil. Someone read Romans 7:21, and then whoever has Ephesians 6:12. Romans 7:21.
I find then a law that when I would do good, evil is present with me.
Paul said, it's always there. I'm trying to do right. We can live as much for God as we want to live. It doesn't eliminate that evil is not there. Evil is always going to abound as long as we're in this world. Someone read Ephesians 6:12.
For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places.
Amen. Evil is always here. We wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers. There is evil that is always present. There is a real enemy against our soul. He is working against us day and night. Now, you may sleep, but the enemy does not sleep. He will combat your mind even at night. You ever wake up and say, man, where did that crazy dream come from? Where did that thought come from? The enemy, he is working. Amen. He is fighting against us. Amen. And if we don't realize that we are engaged in the battle tonight, it can be very detrimental to us. We need to know that we're engaged in the battle. We need to know who we are fighting. And then we need to know that certainly we are going to be the victor. The enemy is going to be defeated. From the very beginning of the Gospels all the way through Revelation, we are warned about an enemy against our soul. That is real. It doesn't mean that we need to fear. It doesn't mean that we need to magnify the devil's power. But still we need to know that he is the prince of the power of the air. And that he rules a very demonic empire. I didn't intend to say this, but I just want to say this. You know, I like harvest things, you know. It's neat going by home that has pumpkins and fall plants out months or whatever out there, and corn stalks, whatever. It looks nice. But I'll tell you what, we're living in a very wicked time. You just look around. Some of you as a travel work, you're driving, man, there's like demonic things everywhere celebrating Halloween. It's just, we live in a wicked world. I mean, it's a very demonic holiday. And in that holiday, people take it very lightly because the devil is very conniving the way that he works. And he is constantly bidding. He's constantly harassing. And it's extremely dangerous for us tonight not to know that the devil and his tactics and his ways, there is an ever-present evil in the hour in which we live. And we have to accept that the present battle that we are engaged in, it's not a human battle. It's a very spiritual battle. Doesn't matter tonight what we are wrestling with. Amen. We can wrestle with sin. We can have struggles. But it's not a character flaw tonight. It's a real spiritual battle. Some folks are saying, well, that's a character flaw. No, it's a spiritual battle that needs to be worked out. And not worked out in the flesh, but worked out in prayer. We will never conquer the enemy on our own. We'll fail every time. It may look like we have the upper hand, but he's wiser and stronger than us. There is an ever-present evil in the hour in which we live. The devil, he never sleeps. He never stops lying, he never stops conniving, he never stops working evil against us. He's trying to destroy our faith. He's trying to bring us to destruction. Someone read 1 Peter 5, 8, 9. Maybe that's what I said. 1 Peter 5, 8, 9. If someone has that.
Be sober and be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, has a roaring lion, walking about seeking whom he may devour. Remember your steadfast in the faith, knowing that the same afflictions are accomplished in your brethren that are in the world.
Amen. We are to be sober. We are to be vigilant. Because our adversary, the devil, he's like a roaring lion. He's trying to seek who he may devour.
Brother Dennis, did you look up Luke 22:31? Go ahead, read that.
The Lord says, Simon, Simon, Satan has desired to have you, that he may sift you as wheat. Page 32.
Go ahead, read that.
But I have prayed for thee, that thy faith fail not. And when thou art covered, strengthen thy brother.
Amen. Brother, right, that's exactly right. Jesus said to Simon, Satan hath desired to sift you as wheat. I'm giving you a warning, Simon, Jesus was saying. The enemy is after your soul. He wants you to be a status quo. He doesn't want you to have a relationship with me. He said, I'm praying for you that your faith fail not. You see, there's an enemy that will tempt us. He will persecute us. He will test us and try to interrupt our prayers. Amen. There is an evil conspiracy that's always against the child of God. Very obvious. And even Simon Peter's life. But Jesus said, I pray for you that your faith fail not. You realize that there was an ever-harassing attack from hell. Simon, you're going to have to work on that. If you and I, as followers of Christ, need to realize that there's an attack on our life. The devil wants us to be the status quo. The devil wants us to fail. He's working against us. And so, the Bible, someone read 1 Thessalonians 2:18. I think I gave that verse.
Wherefore we would have come unto you, even by Paul, once and again, but Satan hindered us.
But Satan hindered us. The enemy is working against us to hinder us. You know, when things arise in our life, I'll be honest, where I'm at and where I was when things started kind of going a little different than we had planned in our life a little over 2 weeks ago. It was very scary for me. But I have to tell you, I had to realize that God is a present help in a time of trouble. I had to get in the Word of God, and my wife and I just began to pray together. We felt God working and moving. So many evenings we come home with our sofa, we knelt down and we prayed. And I got to a place where I had to realize God is a present help. I cannot allow fear to overwhelm me and give me anxiety. Because God has promised that He is my refuge and He is my strength. So this is a new opportunity for God. Though it's taking me by surprise, it is not taking God by surprise. And the enemy would like to strip us and discourage us and hinder our testimony and what God wants to do. That's why I say, hey man, I preach this all the time. I pray, and I pray for services, I pray for you, I'm faithful to the things of God. But as much as I may place it here, still sometimes I think we're inadequate and realizing just how present God is. And so, God says, my grace is sufficient. Amen. You know, the devil, he's not out harassing his children because he has them. He's out harassing God's children because he wants them. Amen. The devil's weapons tonight are aimed at a select few. And I need to tell you, the select few is you. You're here tonight. You're being faithful. The enemy's weapons are aimed against you this evening. Amen. He's after those who seek Christ, those who passionately love the Lord, those who are in the pursuit of prayer, those who are in the pursuit of a deeper relationship with God, those who are determined to walk in the Spirit, amen, and live in the Word of God, amen. Satan has one thing on his mind, and that is to undermine your faith, amen. But I'm here to build that faith. I'm here to encourage you, not through my promise, but through the promise of God's Word. Amen. He says He is a refuge and a strength, a very present help in a time of trouble. Therefore, I will not fear, though the mountains be removed. Amen. And though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea, the waters roar. Amen. God is mistake. Amen. The enemy knows what's happening in the news too. He knows it better than you and I. You know what he knows? That the Lord's return is imminent and soon. And he is working hard. Amen. I want to tell you, amen, I am looking for the Lord to come back very soon.
Amen.
The signs of the times are everywhere. Amen. Everywhere you look, the signs of the time. Jesus is coming back. Amen. I believe that the trumpet, amen, is soon to be sounded. Amen. I believe that God, the Father, is about to send His Son, amen, to catch away the bride. Amen. He's coming back.
Amen.
And we need to be ready. But you know what? The enemy also knows that the time is soon. And he's working very hard to undermine the people of God. But though evil is very present, I need to tell you this. That God is ever present. Be aware of the tactics of the enemy. But be aware that God is ever present. Amen. Amen. God is ever present. Amen. When you are in a time of trouble, when it's persistent, unrelenting, and it seems like evil is ever present, God's help is ever present to help you and I. Amen. Ever present. Amen. Always here, always available, always in great supply. Amen. God is faithful. Amen. He wants us to know that He's there with us. Whether we're in church, whether we're sitting at home, whether we're on the job, whether we're carrying on a conversation with friends, God is present. He is faithful. Amen. He is always there and He always wants to have a relationship with us. Amen. I want you to do something tonight. I want you to make up in your mind and say, I refuse to listen to a lie of Satan. That trouble is everywhere. And he gets me distorted that God's not here. He's good at lying. He's the Father of it. He can make a lie sound better than the truth. Know tonight that God is faithful. And God has equipped us tonight, amen, with everything that we need while we are living in this evil generation and time. Someone look up Psalms 59:19. Someone look up Psalms 59:19. So, I'm sorry, Isaiah. Isaiah 59:19. Just call me dyslexic. I read right and said it wrong. Isaiah 59:19. Someone have it?
So shall they fear the name of the Lord from the west, and His glory from the rising of the sun. When the enemy shall come in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord shall lift up a standard against him.
Amen. Just begin to wave the banner of the Lord. From the north to the south, from the east to the west, the enemy fears the things of God. Because the banner of God is faithful. Amen. The banner of God is righteousness. The banner of God is powerful. The enemy fears that. Amen. Just begin to wave the banner. Amen. Know this, that God is ever present to help us. Amen. There can be ever-present problems as well. Don't think that life is ever going to get simple. There's always going to be problems. So there's ever-present evil. There's an ever-present God. But there probably be ever-present problems. But God is there to help in those problems. I want to read, let me say this. Do you remember what the children of Israel, they forgot about the presence of God. They begin to murmur and complain. We talk about them all the time. I use them as typology probably several times a month. Here they are. So the children of Israel have seen God open the Red Sea. We're familiar with that. Now I want you to remind yourself that a pillar of cloud